Town will wear their away orange uniforms, trimmed in white and blue. Their starters, four seniors. The lone underclassman is a sophomore, Kayla Mayers. And then seniors are Dallas Baldwin, Alex Battle, Kelsey Kazupi, and Tori Smick, who is one of the top scorers in all of South Jersey. She has scored over 500 points this season alone, and she's averaging about 18 a game here for this Woodstown Wolverines team. And as Buddy said, coached by Joe Ursino, they are the seventh seed. They come out of the Tri-County Conference. 17-9 on the season is Woodstown. For Middle Township, coached by John Leahy, they'll wear the home whites, trimmed in black and orange. Starting in the backcourt, Middle Township will only start one senior. Lauren Fields and Juliana Rigitano will start in the backcourt. Lauren Legler will play a swing position. Olivia Schwartz, the lone senior, and Holly McKeg, a junior, will play down low for Middle Township. Fields and Legler, the top two scorers for this middle team. Fields, of course, Buddy, has already gone over 1,000 points for her career.
And, Brian, a good sign here tonight is the junior, Holly McKeg, has re-entered the starting lineup for Coach John Leahy and the Lady Panthers. She came off the bench Monday night and played some quality minutes to get ready for tonight.
They're going to play the anthem. We'll be back right after this with the start of the game. 98.7 The Coast at 987thecoast.com. Go two minutes here. All right, back at Middle Township High School, Brian Kniff, Buddy Tarbottin, and Woodstown against Middle, South Jersey, Group 2 quarterfinal. The officials are Ed Gorski, Dan Bradley, and Bruce Britton.
And Brian, I was actually a little disappointed. Rumor had it that the national anthem was going to be sung by boys' assistant coach, Dr. Richie Trom, but Coach Fracco said he was having a hard time remembering the words, and with his anal retentiveness, I was a little surprised.
That is surprising. Ball is in the air. Woodstown controls the tip. Middle Township comes out straight man-to-man. Woodstown gets it in the post of Mayers. Ball's loose on the floor, and it's picked out of there by Lauren Fields. She wants to run for Middle. Flips a pass up on the left wing to Olivia Schwartz. 18-footer is an air ball long. Rigitano, though, gets the offensive rebound on the weak side. Oh, good look down low from McKeg to Legler, who was open on the block, but the pass wasn't executed well. McKeg threw it off of Legler's feet and out of bounds. Middle to pick up full court man-to-man. Here's Smick. Dribbles it up the right side. Beats the pressure all by herself. Smick bounces over to Baldwin. Dallas Baldwin takes it right side. Shut off. High post pass to Mayers. Mayers turns. Tough angle jumper. Didn't have her shoulder square, but made it from 8 feet away.
That was a tough shot, but give Kayla Mayers credit. She's able to knock it down. Puts her team up 2-0. We're coming up on the 7-minute mark, first quarter.
Fields with it. Left open, fires a three. It's long. Rebound battled for. Falling out of bounds is the Woodstown player, Alex Battle. And Middle Township will have it. 2-0 Woodstown, 6:53 to go first quarter. Fields the inbound. Lobs it to Schwartz. Nice inbound play. Schwartz slipped the screen and was wide open on the near side block. And we have a 2-2 game.
Coaches love to take advantage of those inbounds plays that score under the basket.
Battle with it on the left side. Goes in the high post to Smick. Smick is fouled. One of the middle players had a fistful of jersey there. And it's going to go against Schwartz.
And Olivia Schwartz picks up her first, team's first. 6:32 to play here in the first quarter. We're tied at 2.
Mayers in the high post. Return pass inside to Baldwin. And then Baldwin threw it back. It went through the hands of Battle and then slipped across the division line. And when Battle picked it up, that's a backcourt violation.
And that is the third turnover against Woodstown here in the early going.
2-2 game, 6:20 to go first quarter. We've got a score in group two. Sterling has knocked off the state group one defending champs, Cedar Creek, 61-50. And Willingboro's on their way to a win over Lower Cape May. They were up 50-28 at the half. Here's Legler in the high post. She is fouled. And Lauren Legler will go to the line for two shots.
And that foul is going to be on number 34 for the Wolverines. Dallas Baldwin, the senior. She picks up her first team foul. 5:58 to go here in the opening quarter. Lauren Legler, nothing but the bottom of the net. She will get one more.
Well, you know, she's got a father that played in the NBA and a mother who scored almost 1,500 points here. So you know she's going to be able to shoot free throws.
Yeah, nothing but the bottom of the net twice.
4-2, Middle Township now on top. Kayla Mayers, the forward, is going to bring it up to beat the pressure. Woodstown's big kids obviously can handle the ball. They try to go to Smick in the high post. Middle Township doubles her.
Wow.
But then banking in a shot from 18 feet from the top of the key is Dallas Baldwin. And we're tied at 4. 5.5 to play first quarter. Rigitano on the right side. Goes further on the right into the corner to McKeg. McKeg comes back out high to Fields. Fields top of the key. Uses McKeg's screen. Hesitation move. Gets to the rim. No good, but a foul. And she'll go to the line for two shots.
And a nice little stutter step dribble move there by Lauren Fields. Dallas Baldwin picks up her second, Brian. Team second, 5:22 to go. Fields at the line shooting. Wow, she gets the friendly roll there. That free throw was courtesy of good rotation on the basketball. It hit the front of the rim because the spin was going forward. It rolled in.
And the second free throw is also good. Middle 4-for-4 from the line. They have a 2-point lead at 6-4. Here's Battle against Fields' defense. Battle gives it up to Mayers. Mayers takes it right side, holding the dribble, looking in the post, got it there. But good defense inside, and Baldwin had to kick it out. Now Mayers takes a jumper, no good. Baldwin got the rebound. The ball flicked out of her hands, and now we're going to have a foul on the near side as Kelsey Kazupe picked up the loose ball for for Woodstown. Between Wildwood, Woodstown, and Woodbury, two games and two nights here. But this is definitely Woodstown against Middle Township.
And Lauren Legler picks up her first, team's second.
Mayers into the paint, blocked. Good help defense by Schwartz. And Middle Township has possession, leading by two. 4:45 to go first quarter, 6-4 is the score. Here's Fields in the corner, brings it back out to the right wing, goes high post to Legler, kicked in the corner to Rigitano. They move it quickly. Fields now for three. Bang! And Middle's up 9-4 with 4.5 to go. First quarter. Fields a steal out of the press. Has it on the left wing. Hands off to Legler. Legler goes up high to Schwartz, top of the key. Schwartz now hands off to Fields between the two circles. Coach John Leahy calls a play, and Fields is ready to work. Goes right side to Legler. Legler a long two off the back iron. No good. Mayers the rebound for Woodstown. She gets it up to Kazupe. Kazupe stops, 10-foot jumper, goes off the rim, no good. Rebound brought down by Legler. Middle leading 9-4, inside 4 minutes to go, first quarter. As Lauren Fields trots it up, good start so far for Middle Township, buddy.
Yes, right now the Lady Panthers doing a good job limiting Woodstown to one shot on the offensive end and running their sets when they're in their half-court offense.
Fields down the lane, floater, got it. Got right by the defense, timeout. Woodstown 11-4. Middle leads at 3:31 to go first quarter. We're going to take a quick break. Back after this on 98.7 The Coast. Brian Kniff, Buddy Tarbot, and 11-4. Middle Township leads 3:31 to go first quarter. Girls South Jersey Group 2 quarterfinal. The Lady Panthers playing Woodstown. Woodstown just called a timeout to stop that strong middle surge to start the game. Middle nearly comes up with a steal. Ball's loose. Mayers. And it's finally tied up, and they call a jump ball. And officials doing a good job there, Buddy, of letting that thing go through because the ball was never really tied up. Middle will have it on alternating possession.
And the possession arrow, as you said, Brian, in Middle Township's favor. Woodstown with five turnovers here in the first quarter. 3:06 to play. It's 11-4, Middle Township on top.
A drive on the baseline, Fields, and the ball got blocked from behind by Mayers and out of bounds. Middle will have it.
Good defense that time. Woodstown did a good job as Fields was able to take her girl off the dribble, but help side came over, shutting her off.
They lob it into the post to Schwartz, and she lays it up and in. And it's 13-4 middle.
Same out-of-bounds play they executed on earlier.
Now we have a foul called on Schwartz. That's going to be her second, holding Tori Smick.
And as you said, the senior, number 34, Olivia Schwartz, picks up her second, team's third. The Lady Panthers on a 9-0 run right now.
They lead it 13-4, Buddy. Big Group 2 boys game going on right now. And at the end of one quarter, top-seeded Haddonfield is leading number 8 Willingboro 10-8. Middle Township boys team, of course, has their eye on that score. Should Haddonfield get knocked off, Middle would be at home for the entire South Sectional, as long as they stay alive. Woodstown gets the ball into the post. Mayers misses a turnaround jumper. Middle Township the rebound. Danielle McCann into the game for the first time. She has the ball, got away with a walk, kicks it to Legler, shot no good. Rebound to Olivia Salvo, who checked in for Schwartz, who has two fouls. And now Middle with the ball. Fields down the lane, and she is fouled. Lauren Fields right now, Buddy, is proving to be a handful for the Wolverine defense.
Yeah, right now they do not, and when they're in their man-to-man defense, they don't have anybody that can stay with Lauren Fields when she has the ball in her hands. And that time, just a little, she was out at the top of the key, little fake to her left, and she went right down the right side again, drawing that foul on Tori Smick. It's her, Smick's first, team's third.
Fields was short on the first free throw. She already has 7 points. She's got 7 of Middle's 13 with 2:08 to go in the first quarter.
She shot that first free throw. She was way short.
Fields, the second of 2 free throws. This one is good.
Good adjustment that time by Lauren. She hits nothing but the bottom of the net. 14-4. 10 unanswered points for the Lady Panthers.
Up the floor is Smick to the basket. Good defense by McCann. Made the layup attempt for Smick. Very difficult. She missed it. Legler the rebound. Passes ahead to Fields in the corner. Fields, they walk away from her. She fires a 3 and knocks it down, and Woodstown's got to call another timeout. 17-4 middle. 1:50 to go first quarter. Back after this on 98.7 The Coast. Middle Township High School, South Jersey Group 2 girls quarterfinal. First of a girl-boy doubleheader. We'll have the boys game coming up for you at 8 o'clock as well. Middle Township right now on a 13-0 run here. Game was tied 4-4, and now Middle leads at 17-4. Woodstown's already burned 2 timeouts.
Lauren Fields is 3-for-5 from the floor, 3-for-4 from the foul line.
And she's already got 11 points.
She's 2-for-3 from beyond the arc.
Mayers with it for Woodstown. Flips it back to Allie Satil. Satil just checked into the game. Here's a jump shot on the far side by Kazupe. And now we're going to have a foul called. No, excuse me, not a foul. Ball goes out of bounds off the rebound off of Woodstown.
Kayla Mayers tried to save it, but she was on the end line. And therefore, Middle Township now with the ball. 1:25 to play, first quarter. 17-4, Middle on a 13-0 run.
Here's Legler. Goes to McCann. McCann, top of the lane, shot up is no good. Might have had it partially blocked, but she kept the rebound alive and knocked it off of Sotillo and out of bounds. Erin Ruskey has checked in for Middle. So Middle right now only with Fields and Legler as the lone starter still in the game, as John Leahy with this 13-point lead feeling very comfortable going deep into his bench. Here's Fields for three. That's short. Good inbound play as Fields got an open look. Woodstown has the ball. Kayla Mayers lobs it in the post. Stolen away. The pass was too high for Smick. Here comes Legler across midcourt. Surveys the defense. Now goes to Ruskey in the corner. Ruskey back to Legler. Legler holds. Now it's Danielle McCann. McCann looks for a cutter. It's not there, so she puts the ball on the floor and goes to Legler. Left elbow. Legler flips it over to Fields. Fields behind McCann's screen. Baseline drive. Shut off. Goes to McCann on the right wing. Danielle McCann walks it back out. Now it's Lauren Legler resetting the offense between the two circles. And John Leahy, I believe, wants his team to hold for one shot as we're down inside 25 seconds to go in the first quarter. Fields right now is being guarded by Smick, and that's a bad matchup for Woodstown. Fields is just going by her and bringing it back. Now here's Legler right down the lane. Got it in the foul. Fields found Legler. Yeah. Legler was took a hack across the arm as she floated up the shot. She knocks it down, and she'll go to the line to try to complete a three-point play, and it's all Middle Township right now at 19-4 with 8 seconds to go in the first quarter.
And a great decision that time, Brian, by Lauren Fields. She got excellent dribble penetration, got inside the foul line on the right side. Lauren Legler fouled her in from the left, and as the defense came to Fields, she flipped it back to Legler, who went right down the belly of the Woodstown defense, drew the foul, and she finishes the three-point play.
Woodstown hasn't scored a point, buddy, in 5.5 minutes. Here's Smick, turned it over with 2 seconds to go, and Middle will simply hold the ball as the buzzer sounds. A thoroughly convincing advantage after one quarter for Middle Township. They lead it 20-4. They finish the quarter on a 16-0 run. Back after this on 98.7 The Coast and 987thecoast.com. And right now they have a comfortable 20-4 lead over Woodstown, who didn't score a point for the last 5.5 minutes of the first quarter here in the South Jersey Group 2 girls quarterfinal. And the winner will play on Friday night against either Collingswood or Cinnaminson.
Middle shot 6-for-12 from the floor in that first quarter, 6-of-7 from the foul line. They turned it over just once. Woodstown turned it over 7 times and shooting 2-for-7.
Smick, Woodstown's leading scorer, has been held scoreless so far.
She only got 1 shot attempt in that first quarter.
Battle looking in the post to Smick. She dropped the pass under heavy duress and it goes out of bounds.
Middle Township just doing a outstanding job in their man-to-man half-court defense, really making it tough on Tori Smick, one of the leading scorers in South Jersey.
Here's a steal by Battle, and she's bumped and fouled by McCann. Good play by Alex Battle. Stolen away from Danielle McCann.
And Danielle McCann picks up her fourth team foul, just the second turnover against Middle Township here in the first half.
Woodstown with the basketball. They lob it into the post. Ball was tipped away and picked up by Legler of Middle Township. They are really shutting off the passing lanes into the post is Middle Township. Marina Peterson into the game for Middle. And now it's Lauren Legler on the wing. Legler goes back to Fields. Going to try to run a high pick and roll with Legler. Fields lost possession. Smick came up with the loose ball. Smick to the basket. Her layup is good. That's her first field goal.
Yeah, so that time Tori Smick picked Lauren Fields' pocket, and then she took it the length of the floor, and she laid it in. 20-6. Snaps the 16-0 run.
Fields for three. That's short. Rebound is going to go out of bounds off of Woodstown. That basket by Woodstown, buddy, was their first in 7 minutes of action. John Leahy wants a timeout. 20-6, middle on top. 6:21 to go, second quarter. Back after this on 98.7 The Coast and 98.7 The Coast. That Buddy Tarbot and Matt Ulmer on the video on 98.7thecoast.com. 20-6, Middle Township leads Woodstown with 6:21 to go in the second quarter of this South Jersey Group 2 girls quarterfinal. Another girls score in the fourth quarter. Willingboro leads Lower Cape May 64-40, so it looks like the top-seeded Chimeras will advance. And we also have a boys score from that Haddonfield-Willingboro game. And Haddonfield leads Willingboro by two at 16-14 with 2:03 to go in the second quarter.
Are you sure Willingboro is not the Chimeras?
We have an illegal screen called against Middle Township. If you want an answer to that question, I'm going to tell you no, I'm not sure. So Middle turns it over.
That personal foul on Marina Peterson, her first, team's fifth. I'm sure that's not the way John Leahy drew up that play during the timeout.
Kayla Mayers across midcourt. Now it's Alex Battle between the circles. Flips it over to Mayers on the left side. Mayers steps in, 17-footer is way long. And we're going to have a foul called against Dallas Baldwin, I believe. Now they're going to call it against Smick for pushing off from behind.
And Tori Smick will pick up her second, team's fifth. Tori Smick's got to be feeling a little frustrated, Brian. She's only been able to get two field goal attempts, and the one she created on her own when she picked Fields' pocket and went the length of the floor to score.
Backdoor look from Peterson in the post. Ball was tipped away, but great pass by Rigitano to Fields for three. Knocks it down from the baseline. Fields with 14 points already with 5.5 to go in the first half. Here's Smick up the right side. Goes to Battle, top of the key. Battle to Mayers in the post. It's tipped away. Loose ball. Kazupe picks it up. Now Smick on a jumper that's no good. Gets a return feed after Woodstown gets the rebound. Got it and a foul. As Smick went down the lane, was off balance, took a bump, laid it up and in, and she'll go to the line.
And they're gonna call that foul number 55, Holly McKeag. And you could see that Tori Smick with that scorer's mentality. She did a great job with that dribble penetration into the lane. She drew the contact and feathered it with a beautiful touch up towards the basket. And she buries the free throw to finish the three-point play the old-fashioned way. Smick now with 5 points. And it's Middle Township 23, Woodstown 9.
Olivia
5-10 to play first half.
Olivia Salvo back into the game for Middle. Here's Fields, goes right side to Peterson. Peterson holding against the defensive pressure of Kazube. Now it's Rigitano, left side. Rigitano to Legler, top of the key. Uses Rigitano's ball screen, try to high pick and roll. Legler's pass back to Rigitano was too high, and they turn it over. Here's Kazube. Hands off to Battle.
Fourth turnover against Middle.
Battle on the right wing, picked up by Fields. Enters into the post to Mayers. Mayers kicks it out to Baldwin. 18-footer, no good. Rebound in the post and flipped up and in by Kazupe. And a little 7-3 surge by Woodstown to start this second quarter. It's 23-11 Middle.
Just what Coach Joe Arsino needed his Wolverines to do. Just get back into this game. They're not going to get it all at once.
Rigitano, a bad pass. Stolen away by Kazupe. Kazupe to the basket. Missed the layup. Rebound Smick. That's no good. And the rebound will go off of Middle and out of bounds.
And right now, Woodstown has an opportunity to cut the lead to 10. And when they were trailing 20-4 at the end of the first quarter, nice play.
Baldwin got it to Smick on screen for the screener, and she laid it up and in. And Tori Smick is heating up. She's got 7. Middle Township leads it by 10 at 23-13. But Middle was ahead 20-6. Here's Schwartz through the lane. No good on the shot. Got her own rebound. Got the shot blocked. Woodstown the rebound. Here comes Alex Battle. Lobs it up to Smick. It's too far and out of bounds.
And that is not what Woodstown needed to do. That was a tough angle. Actually, there was no angle there, and the ball just floated out of bounds. Woodstown in that situation, Brian, just needed to get it over half court, set up their offense. They had an opportunity to further cut into this Middle Township lead. It's 23-13, 3:25 to play, first half.
Legler on the right side. Dribble penetrates, goes to Fields. Deep three, off the iron, no good. Nice play by Rigitano to tip it out to a teammate to keep it alive for her team. They get an extra possession. Right side is Fields. Fields on the floor, goes to Schwartz for three. Off the iron, didn't get the friendly roll. The rebound to Smick, had the ball knocked out of her hands momentarily. Picks it up, drives through the lane. Floater, off the glass, no good. Got her own rebound and is fouled.
And again, Tori Smick showing why she is so dangerous offensively. She was able to get a pretty decent look at that basket, put herself in a good position to rebound her own miss. Then she draws contact, goes to the line to shoot two. Nothing but the bottom of the net on her first one. She will get one more. It's 23-14. Woodstown climbing back into this game.
The second free throw is also good. So it's 2:52 to play in the first half. And Woodstown has cut a 14-point deficit to 8. Here's another steal by the Wolverines. Spinning is Smick, left-handed off the glass, no good. Rebound to Salvo. And Middle Township will have it. Middle needs a bucket on this possession here.
Yeah, Middle turned it over just one time in that first quarter. They've turned it over 5 times here in period number 2.
McCann is fouled on the wing by Battle.
And Alex Battle, number 11, the senior, she picks up her first.
Legler comes back in, replaces McCann.
Team 6th. Both teams will be shooting free throws for the rest of the half. 2:25 to play. Middle on top, 23-15.
Ruski on the right side for Middle Township. She just checked in moments ago. Now it's Fields. Goes to Legler. She's bumped and fouled by Mayers. That's going to put Legler on the line for a 1-1.
Kayla Mayers. That's her second personal foul. The sophomore is the second leading scorer on this Woodstown team. And Coach Joe Arsino subs her out very quickly.
Legler rattles home the first free throw.
Shooter's touch on that one.
She's got 6 points in the game.
Lauren
Middle
Legler
on top, 24-15. 2:17 to go before halftime. Second free throw is long. Rebound to Baldwin. Up ahead quickly. Shot up from the wing is no good by Kara Wildermuth, who just checked in. Wildermuth could shoot it. She's made 45 three-pointers this year off the bench for Woodstown. Here's Smick, kicks it in the corner to Wildermuth. Now she has it up top, goes to Battle. To Wildermuth again on the right wing. Holden goes to Baldwin. Baldwin top of the key. To Wildermuth again on the right side. In the high post, through the hands of Smick, stolen away by Ruski. Ruski down the middle, she was 1-on-2 and does the smart thing by stopping, goes to Legler. Oh, but then Legler going to the basket, had the ball slip out of her hands and out of bounds. McCann and McKeg. Woodstown, come back in for Middle Township.
Woodstown has turned it over 11 times in this first half. Middle Township 7. 6 in this quarter, Brian.
Here's Battle for Woodstown. Got it to Baldwin. Her 3 is no good. Long rebound tracked down by Woodstown. Good backdoor look from Kazupe to Smick, and she lays it in. And now it's a 7-point game at 24-17. Tale of two quarters so far.
Woodstown's outscored Middle 13-4 here in period number 2.
Here's Ruski, a baseline drive floater. No good off the iron. Rebound brought down by Baldwin. Stolen away by Legler. Legler to Fields. Fields tees up a 3. Bang! Big turn of events there in Middle's favor as they restore a 10-point lead. 45 seconds to go in the quarter. Here's Kazupe. Gets it up to Wildermuth. Wildermuth hands it back to Kazupe. In between the two circles now. Bounces it back to Battle. Battle goes high post to Smick, and she's tied up. That'll be a jump ball possession to Middle Township.
And as you said, Brian, that last big bucket by Lauren Fields, it's 24-17, Woodstown with the ball, an opportunity to further cut into the lead, but they turn it over quickly. Then Lauren Legler finds Lauren Fields, and Fields buries the 3 to put her team back up 10.
Middle in a delay offense here to try to take the last shot. 14 seconds to go. And now Fields looks like she's ready to run a high pick and roll with Schwartz. Takes it right side. Down the lane and is fouled. Battle got there late coming over in help side, and Fields will go to the line for 2 shots.
And that
Lauren
foul,
Fields, buddy, excuse me, already has 17 points in this first half.
Well, the problem is in this man-to-man defense that Woodstown's playing, they have nobody that can stay with Lauren Fields.
Free throw is no good. She'll get another. Middle on top, 27-17, 6.8 seconds to go in the first half.
And again, a little shake and bake out at the top of the key, and Lauren Fields finds the seam, drives down the right side, and as you said, Battle came over late. Fowler sends her to the line.
Second free throw is good. So Middle up 11, 28-17. Here's Battle. Battle lobs it ahead to Kazupe. Kazupe high post to Smick through the lane. No good, but a foul. And she's going to go to the line for 2 shots as she was fouled at the buzzer.
And they're going to call that foul on Danielle McCann. It's going to be her 2nd, team's 8th.
So with no one along the free throw lane, Smick will shoot 2 foul shots as the quarter has ended. She makes the first. It's 28-18, and she makes the second, 28-19 at the close of 2 quarters, as Woodstown gets back in it with a big run in the second quarter. Halftime at Middle Township, Lady Panthers lead at 28-19, South Jersey Group 1 quarterfinal, and we'll be back with the halftime report right after this on 98.7 The Coast at 98.7thecoast.com.
Willingboro's girls team is. They just put 87 points on the board against a very good defensive team in Lower Cape May, beating them 87-56. Woodstown will have the ball to start the second half here, trailing by 9.
Had to run down to use the facilities in the boys' locker room. Ran right into Dr. Trom, Brian.
Right.
He wanted to give me a free checkup. I said, I'll pass.
Thank you. Kelly Kazupe from Woodstown goes over to Alex Battle. Into the post. Pass is too high and out of bounds. So Middle forces a turnover to start the third. I think the first 4 minutes of this third quarter,
yes,
buddy, are going to be critical. Woodstown cut into that 16-point lead, got it down to 9. We'll see what happens here to start the third quarter. Here's Rigitano, goes to Schwartz. Schwartz along the baseline to Legler. Legler, top of the key now, kicks in the corner to Rigitano. Back to Legler, right elbow jumper, didn't get the roll. Long rebound goes right out into the hands of Fields, though. Back to Legler. Legler thought about a 3, now puts the ball on the floor, takes it to the elbow, kicks out. Schwartz along 2, off the iron, no good. Rigitano, the offensive rebound, got it back out to Schwartz. Right side to Fields. John Leahy calls out a play, Middle getting multiple opportunities on this possession to start the second half.
Rigitano to Schwartz in the corner to Fields. Fields, a baseline drive off the glass, too hard. Rebound goes off of Woodstown and out of bounds.
And that's three shot attempts for Middle Township here to start the third quarter. Unable to get any to drop, but again, they get another offensive opportunity as the ball goes off of Woodstown.
Here's Schwartz for three, off the iron, no good. McKeg, the offensive rebound. Fields for three, bang! Middle got five shots on that possession, buddy. And now they lead it by 12 at 31-19.
And Holly McKeg did a good job corralling that long offensive rebound and finding her teammate, Fields.
Smicka drive, no good on the shot. Rebound goes off of Middle and out of bounds.
Yeah, Brian, when you get five opportunities in one possession, you better come away with something.
That's the truth. Woodstown to inbound. And we have a five-second violation. Can't get it inbounds. 6:26 to go, third quarter.
So that's two possessions for the Wolverines and two turnovers. They've now turned it over 15 times.
Fields with it. Right side to Legler. Legler a deep two. Got it from 18 feet.
Legler did a good job coming off that screen.
Timeout, Woodstown. We're going to keep it here. It's a 30-second timeout. As Woodstown did a great job in that second quarter, cutting that Middle lead to nine, but now Middle gets the first five of the third quarter, and they're back up 33-19.
Well, Brian, as I just said, the first two times down the floor with the ball, Woodstown did not get a shot off. They turned it over twice. The Middle Township comes down, and they get five opportunities in one offensive possession as they got three offensive rebounds. Then the ball went out of bounds off of the Wolverines. Then Holly McKeg corralled that long rebound. She found Lauren Fields on the left side beyond the arc. Lauren able to knock it down. Then Middle ran a nice play there to Lauren Legler coming off a screen on the right block. Lauren catches the ball, faces, and she buries the jump shot for two. 6 minutes.
Here's Baldwin off a set play for Woodstown. Knocks down an 18-foot jumper.
And good execution out of a timeout by Woodstown. Coach Joe Orsino has got to be happy with that. He's got to stop the bleeding again.
Legler just to the right of the top of the key. Holds against Mayers. Spins away from some pressure. Goes down low to Rigitano. Great pass across to an open McKeg. And she'll go to the line for two shots as she was fouled.
And there, Lauren Legler drives the right side. The help defense comes to her. She bounces the ball down low to Rigitano, and Olivia does a good job. Juliana does a good job of finding McKeg on the left side, wide open.
McKeg missed the first foul shot. 33-21, Middle on top. Second free throw is short. The rebound is brought down by Smick. And Woodstown has possession, trailing by 12, 5.5 to go third quarter. Smick on the left side, picked up by Schwartz. Bounces over to Mayers. Mayers at the foul line area. Goes back out to battles between the circles. Battle over to Kazupe on the right wing. Kazupe, left-handed dribble, steps in. 17-footer is way short. Rebound is taken by McKeg. And now here's Fields trotting it up across the division line. Goes to Legler. Legler into the lane. Some contact, no foul called. And Woodstown running the other way. Here's Smick. Smick trying to get to the basket, no good, but a foul. Legler went one dribble too far there, buddy. There was some contact in there, but I don't think the referees wanted to bail her out. She should have just hit that spot and elevated for that 12-foot jumper.
Yeah, she got good penetration into the lane. That's where she needs to come to that jump stop. Take that little short jumper. And you're right, they were not going to bail her out.
In that big Group 2 boys game, Haddonfield hit five threes in the third quarter. They now lead Willingboro 40-32 going into the fourth. Second free throw by Smick is good. She missed the first. That was her first miss from the line in the game. She is now 6-for-7 and has 14 points. Middle leads at 33-22, 4:50 to go in the third quarter. Lady Panthers with possession. Schwartz on the left side. Flips it back out high to Fields. Fields goes over to Rigitano on the right wing. Entered it into the post to McKeg. and too hot to handle. McKeg tried to save it inbounds. It goes off the back of the backboard, and that is out of bounds.
And that's going to be the eighth turnover against Middle Township, the first one here in the second half. 4:30 to play, third quarter, 33-22, Middle Township on top.
Battle into the post. Ball's tipped away, but Smick gets it to the right elbow, into the lane, and she traveled. She had the ball batted out of her hands, went right back to her, and then she shuffled her feet.
Yes, that Tori Smick was determined to try and take that ball to the hole, but Middle Township doing a good job collapsing, getting in there and help defense, taking a clear path to the basket away, and then she turned it over.
Fields across midcourt, right side to Legler. Legler holds, goes in the corner to Aaron Ruske. Ruske just checked into the game, so did Danielle McCann. McCann has the ball on the left wing now, hands off to Legler. Legler dribbles away from some pressure. They leave her alone. She fires a three. It's no good. Rebound, Ruske. Layup, no good, but a foul. And Aaron Ruske will go to the line for two shots.
Aaron Ruske doing a good job in recognizing and crashing the boards. That personal foul is going to be on Alex Battle, number 11 for Woodstown. It's going to be her third, second team foul. Ruske at the line shooting two. She buries the first free throw. She will get one more. 3:53 to play. It's 34-22.
Second free throw also good. Now Middle's up by 13. And they've had a pretty good start to this third quarter. Here's Allie Satil for Woodstown. Takes the ball down the right wing against Lauren Fields. Bounces back out to Kayla Mayers. Mayers behind a screen, gets it in the post to Smick. Tied up nicely. And we have a jump ball. The Woodstown fans are yelling because Lauren Fields had something to say to Smick, but I think what they didn't see was after the jump ball was called, Smick gave Lauren Fields a little whack across the chest, buddy.
Yeah, Tori Smick obviously getting a little frustrated. She snapped out of it in that second quarter and had a good offensive outburst.
Here's Fields in the corner against Smick. Backs away. Lobs in the post nicely to Legler, and the layup is good.
Great job there. Lauren Legler going back door. Lauren Fields recognizing, finding her teammate for a wide open layup on the right side of the basket. It's now 37-22, 3:04 to play, third quarter.
High post pass to Smick. Smick bounces in the corner to Wildermuth for three. That's off the rim, no good. Mayers the rebound, stripped. Ball's loose on the floor, picked up by McCann. She dribbles out of pressure. Fields had knocked the ball away. We've seen Lauren Fields play some good games, buddy. This is one of her best right now on both ends of the floor. Fields on the right wing, dribble drive, goes to Legler. 19-footer, was just inside the three-point line. No good on the shot. Rebound to Woodstown. Smick lobs it ahead. Ball is loose as the pass was errant. And now here comes Middle. Fields on the wing, trying to go around Smick. Smick blocked the shot. Rebound is going to go off of Woodstown and out of bounds. Wildermuth came up with it. Fields reached in and knocked the ball off her leg and out of bounds. Salvo will come in. Olivia Schwartz to replace Legler.
Tori Smick did a good job defensively that time on Lauren Fields.
Fields behind a screen for three. In and out. Rebound McCann, and she is fouled. And Danielle McCann will get two shots.
And again, that time Danielle McCann goes to the glass instead of standing there watching Lauren Fields shoot the ball. She did a good job, good reaction. And that's why she's the recipient of the offensive rebound, draws the foul.
McCann makes the first. That matches Middle's largest lead of the game. It's 16. It's now 38-22.
There's a some sort of malfunction going on with the clock.
Well, I think it just looked down.
Yeah, might have something to do with the amount of mustard on his pretzel.
McCann missed the second free throw. And now it's Woodstown with the ball. Satil on the wing, comes back out to Baldwin. Baldwin between the circles, goes to Satil on the right side. Satil takes the ball down the right wing, across the baseline, kicks out to Kazupe. 18-footer is no good. Baldwin the rebound in the post. Good little move, but couldn't finish. Rebound goes off of middle and out of bounds. 1:32 to go third quarter. It's 38-22, Middle Township on top.
And Woodstown continues to hit the offensive glass.
Entered into the post to Smick, and her layup is good right off the inbound play.
Good execution that time by the Wolverines. 38-24, 1:20 to go, third quarter. Middle Township on top.
Schwartz on the right wing. Pulled the string on the pass. Ball was loose momentarily, but the ball ended up getting batted right back into her hands. Now it's Fields between the two circles. Fields takes the ball past Smick. Now it's kicked out to Ruski. Now Schwartz for three. That's short. Rebound. Battled for. It's going to go off of Woodstown and out of bounds.
And that definitely was the proper call. You hear a lot of moaning and groaning coming from right below us where the Woodstown faithful are sitting. But Woodstown right now just a step slower than the Lady Panthers.
Here's Schwartz, top of the key for Middle Township. Right side to Legler. Legler puts the ball on the floor against Mayers. Takes it toward the lane, gives off to Ruski. Ruski high post pass to McKeg. Good head and shoulders fake, but then she shuffled her feet.
And again, Holly McKeg has been out of the lineup with an injury. She missed a couple of games. She was finally able to play Monday night coming off the bench, and she did rather well. Obviously, she played good enough that Coach John Leahy was able to insert her.
Satil just traveled against the defense of Fields. Matching turnovers there. And now Marina Peterson will check in, replacing McKeg.
Brian, that was the 21st turnover against Woodstown. They've turned it over eight times here in this third quarter.
Here's Fields. Lobs it to Legler. 25 seconds to go in the period. And a foul on Mayers. That's not a good foul. 28, 29 feet from the basket.
Now, that's Kayla Mayers, the sophomore, Brian, picks up her third, team's fourth, especially with 25 seconds left to play in the third quarter. But again, just a sophomore, second leading scorer on this team. She is now subbed out, under 20 seconds to go, third quarter.
Middle with the ball. Here's Fields between the two circles. 13 seconds to go. She looks like she's ready to run a play. Takes the ball down the right side. Floats in through the lane.
Wow.
Got the friendly roll.
What a tough shot by Fields. Again, good body control by the junior.
Satil won't be able to get the ball up the floor to get a shot away. And Middle dominates the third quarter, and they now lead it 40-24 as we head into the fourth. Back after this on 98.7 The Coast at 98.7thecoast.com.
Dominates
that third quarter. They outscore Woodstown 12-5 and extend their lead back to 16 points. They lead it 40-24 in the South Jersey Group 2 quarterfinal. The winner plays Friday night against either Collingswood or Cinnaminson. If it's Middle Township, it'll be here, and we'll have the game for you on the air. By the way, if you're looking for Wildwood Catholic, they are airing right now over on 106.3, the Rock Alternative. So spin over there, and then, of course, we're going to have the boys' game between Middle and Cinnaminson here at 8 o'clock on the Coast.
Phil Pizzi and Dennis Brown bringing you all the action from 15th and Central.
Here's another turnover by Woodstown to start the fourth quarter. Fields through the lane, and then she turned it over. She got too far in there and didn't have an angle to pass. Smick down the lane, off the glass,
wow.
And good.
Tough shot by Tori Smick, but again, showing her athletic ability, and she's also showing why she is a scorer. She's got that scorer's mentality.
Here's Fields. Now it's Legler. Baseline drive. Bounces across. McKeg, layup. Got it.
Great job by Lauren Fields. Driving the right baseline. Help defense comes to her. She finds her teammate, Holly McKeg, wide open on the left side of the rim. and Holly uses the glass and lays it in.
Battle goes right side to Kazubay. Kazubay holds, goes to Mayers in the corner. Mayers stops, lobs a pass across to Battle. Battle looking in the post. Good front defense by Legler, but then they get her for a foul, holding off on Baldwin.
That's why it was so good.
Exactly. So Woodstown.
Well, I'll tell you what, Lauren Legler is the total package. She does everything, including take out the trash for this team.
Here's a three-pointer that's way short by Baldwin, but the ball comes right back to her as it went off the side of the backboard. Then she airballs the second attempt, and Middle Township has it. Legler across the division line, top of the key, right down the lane. Took a bump, no call, and now Woodstown takes possession. Here's Smick on the right wing. Smick, foul line jumper, got the roll.
Did I say scorer's mentality?
No kidding.
What a tough
shot. She's got
shot.
20. Smick has 20 of her team's 28. Here's Fields.
That young lady is a player.
And now Mayers reaches in and commits really a silly foul out on the wing on McKeg, and that's going to be her fourth.
Yes, it is. Sophomore picks up her fourth. 6:03 to go in the game. Middle Township on top, 42-28. That's going to be the fifth team foul against the Wolverines.
Fields to Peterson, top of the key to Schwartz. Schwartz to Legler. Legler, 18-footer, rattles in and out. Rebound to Peterson, but she lost it as a Woodstown player came in to the area, and the Wolverines will have it. 42-28, Middle still on top, 5:49 to go in the game. Here's Kazupe, goes to Smick, left side to Baldwin. Now it's Alex Battle, and we have an illegal screen called against Dallas Baldwin.
And Dallas Baldwin, she will pick up her third, team's sixth. Woodstown coach Joe Arsino not happy with that call, and neither was Dallas Baldwin. Both pleading their case.
Fields.
Nonetheless, they won't change it.
Fields goes to Schwartz on the wing. It's Middle Township, a 14-point lead in the ball. Here's McKeg on the right side. McKeg to Legler, top of the key. Legler spinning to the right elbow. Shoots, spins in and out. Rebound taken by McKeg, and she gets it out to Fields. Fields on the right side. John Leahy instructs her to back it away. Fields takes it into the corner, double-teamed, had the ball knocked out of her hands by Smick and out of bounds.
Tori Smick trying to plead her case, saying that she was able to knock that ball off of Lauren Fields.
Middle to inbound, and now it's Fields.
Under 5 minutes to go in the game.
Top of the key, kicks, Legler fakes a three, steps in, 17-footer. That one's in and out, and now the foul over the back. Goes on Schwartz. Excuse me, not Schwartz, McKeg.
And Holly McKeg will pick up her second, third team foul. Lauren Legler is just having a very tough time right now offensively in this game tonight.
Buddy, here's an incredible turn of events in that Haddonfield-Willingboro boys game. Willingboro has come back. They trail by three with 3 minutes left. A fire alarm was pulled in the gym, and everyone has to exit the building. We have a foul inside on Middle Township here, and this is going to send Kayla Mayers to the line for two shots.
And they're going to call that foul on number 23, Lauren Fields. Lauren picks up her first, team's fourth. It's going to send Kayla Mayers to the line shooting two.
Did not get the roll on the first one. 42-28.
She is the first Woodstown player to go to the foul line in this basketball game, not named Tori Smick. Smick is 6 of 7, and Mayers misses her first. And she hits the second one. 44-29, 4:41 to go in the game.
Woodstown showing some full court pressure here, but now they back off as soon as Middle gets it in.
And that game is being hosted by Haddonfield.
The winner of this game plays the winner of Cinnaminson and Collingswood. Cinnaminson right now leads by 12 after three quarters. We've got our moles all over South Jersey getting the scores tonight, buddy. Middle here with a 13-point lead in the ball. Clock approaching 4 minutes to play in the basketball game. Here's Schwartz, a jumper from 17 feet is good.
Good job that time by Lauren Legler. Good dribble penetration. Finds her teammate wide open on the left side. And Olivia Schwartz knocks down the jump shot.
Kazubé to Baldwin, top of the key. Back to Kazubé on the right side. To Battle. Battle top of the key. Drives the lane. Blocked by Schwartz. Here comes Fields trying to run for Middle Township. Oh, throws it behind Legler and out of bounds.
That was a good defensive play by Olivia Schwartz. 44-29, 3:40 to go in the game. Middle Township on top comfortably by 15.
Schmidt goes to Baldwin, top of the key. Baldwin to Battle, looking in the post. That's an offensive foul. Oh, wow, they call this on Schwartz. Schmidt and Schwartz were battling, and Schmidt kind of spun her body and displaced Schwartz. That foul really should have gone the other way. But they call it on Middle Township, and Woodstown will inbound.
Olivia Schwartz picks up her third, and you are right. It looked like it was going to be an offensive foul. Fifth team foul.
They get it in the post to Schmick. Shot was blocked, and now it goes off of Schmick and out of bounds.
And again, Olivia Schwartz comes back. That's three good defensive plays in a row by Olivia Schwartz, the senior, really making herself – her presence felt, I should say, on the defensive end.
Middle with the basketball, leading by 15, and now John Leahy wants a timeout. 3:18 to go in the game, Middle 44, Woodstown 29, South Jersey Group 2 girls quarterfinal. Back after this on 98.7 The Coast and 98.7thecoast.com. 31, 1:51 to go. Second free throw's no good. Woodstown with the ball. They got to work quickly. 1:45 to go. Schmick, top of the key. Fires the three.
Wow.
Bang. Wow. Timeout. Woodstown. It's 45-34 with 1:40 to go. We'll take a break. Matt Ulmer on the video. 45-34, Middle Township leading Woodstown. 1:40 to go in the basketball game.
And that was Tori Schmick's first three-point shot of the game, Brian. Woodstown has only taken four. They were 0-for-3 up until that point. And Schmick knocked that one down from NBA range. Tori Schmick does a good job driving, trying to get to the basket.
The problem right now for Woodstown, buddy, is that they're basically a one-trick pony. Schmick has 25 of the 34. Aaron Ruske way ahead of the pack for middle. Rigitano to the basket, missed the layup. Rebound to Woodstown. And now they're going to push. They can get it inside single digits. Schmick on the right side. Working against Schwartz. Baseline drive, and she is fouled.
And she just does a good job as she drives that right baseline, dipping, getting her shoulder and her head around the defender to draw that contact.
End of one quarter, Group 4 boys. Atlantic City leads Southern Regional 11-8.
And Olivia Schwartz picks up her fourth, team's sixth.
Schmick missed the free throw.
She missed it long, banged it off the back of the rim.
McKeg checks back in for Rigitano.
Tori Schmick now 6 of 8. Oh, she misses the second one hard off the back of the iron
Schwartz,
as well.
Schwartz the rebound, and now it's Fields. 1:15 to go in the game. Middle by 11. Fields across midcourt. Goes to Legler. Legler picked up by Mayers. Legler to Fields. Middle running its delay offense here. Legler holds. Still dribbling. And now is fouled by Battle. And Legler will go to the line for a 1-1. And Woodstown really let Middle just take too much time off the clock on that possession.
Yeah, 58 seconds, absolutely.
Yeah, inside a minute, and Middle with an 11-point lead. Middle jumped out to a 20-4 lead after one quarter, and the closest that Woodstown has got after that was 8. And that was in the second quarter. Legler makes the front end of the 1-1.
Nothing but the bottom of the net.
She's got 11 points for the game. And she's 5-for-6 from the line. Second free throw is also good.
Lauren Legler's played an excellent floor game here tonight, Brian.
Here's Battle. Bounces to Baldwin. Foul line jumper goes off the rim. No good. Rebound to Legler. Legler dribbles away. Goes to Fields. Fields. Cross midcourt. And is bumped and fouled by Smick, and she'll go to the line for a 1-1.
And Tori Smick picks up her fourth, they both begin with an F, her fourth personal foul, the 9th team foul against the Wolverines. It's going to send Lauren Fields to the line to shoot a 1-1. 38.4 seconds to play in this basketball game. Middle Township on top, 47-34.
Fields makes the first. We're being told now, buddy, that the teams have re-entered the floor up at Haddonfield. That game was stopped with 3 minutes left in the third quarter. Haddonfield leading Willingboro by 3 because of a pulled fire alarm. Fields' second free throw is also good. She has 26 points. And Middle Township's going to take a timeout, a 30-second timeout. We'll keep it right here. Middle leads it 49-34, so they are on their way to winning here with 38 seconds to go. And at last report, it looked like Sinnott-Minson was leading Collingswood in the other quarterfinal, 30-18 at the close of 3. Middle Township will move on to play the winner of that game, and that game will be here on Friday. And it'll be a 6 p.m. game, and we will have it for you here on 98.7 The Coast and 987thecoast.com. And if Matt Ulmer starts getting more equipment, we're going to have to ask Middle to build an annex to this press box up here. Here comes Woodstown trailing by 15. Smick, top of the key. And we're going to have an illegal screen called on Dallas Baldwin.
And Dallas Baldwin, the senior, she picks up her fourth. 31 seconds to go. Her fourth, team's 10th. So that's a player control foul, not a non-shooting foul. Middle will be at the line the rest of the way, shooting 2.
Legler handling the ball here. Fields has already checked out of the game. Legler up to Rusky. 20 seconds left in the game. And now we're going to have a foul called on Kara Wildermuth. And that's going to send Lauren Legler to the line for 2 shots.
And Wildermuth picks up her second. And as we said, the team is at the 10-foul limit.
Free throw is good.
Nothing but the bottom of the net for Lauren Legler,
who is 7-for-8 from the line.
And as I had said earlier, she's played an excellent floor game. She just does all of the little things that do not show up in a box score.
Second free throw is good. And Legler checks out. Middle leads it. Now they have their largest lead of the game, 51-34. Woodstown's going to call timeout with 15 seconds left. And we will keep it right here for the final 15 seconds of this one. Of course, coming up at 8, it's Middle Township and Sinnott-Minson in boys action. And if you're looking for the Wildwood Catholic game, the Crusaders playing modern day. And we'll be serving that one up for you over on 106.3 WJSE, the Rock Alternative. So that game is in the first quarter.
And right now, with 15 seconds left, as you said, Woodstown calls a timeout. Lauren Legler was just subbed out prior to the timeout being called to a well-deserved round of applause. Lauren Legler and Lauren Fields, one heck of a 1-2 punch for these Lady Panthers. But Olivia Schwartz also had a good game, as did Juliana Rigitano. and Holly McKay. You know the Panthers were glad to get her back on the floor.
Smick into the lane, off the glass, no good. Rebound to Schwartz. Goes to Peterson, and Peterson doesn't even have to go across midcourt. Gets it to Schwartz, and that'll do it. Middle wins it, 51-34, and they will advance in the South Jersey Group 2 tournament. We'll take a break. We'll come back right after this. Little post-game show, 98.7 The Coast and 987thecoast.com.
Well, the Middle Township Lady Panthers just advanced in the quarterfinals with a very impressive win over Woodstown, 51-34. The Lady Panthers will be home here on Friday night at 6 o'clock.
That's it.
They will be playing the winner of the Cinnaminson-Collingswood game, which we will have those results at some point during the boys' game. And right now we're going to go to half court where Brian Kniff has Lauren Fields, the leading scorer for the Lady Panthers.
All right, down on the floor with Lauren Fields. Lauren, congratulations on the win. You had a big first quarter, and you guys just held the lead from there.
Yeah, that was what we wanted to do, come out very strong and make sure we got on this team early.
They had a real good second quarter against you, and they got your lead down to single digits. What did you guys talk about at halftime?
We talked about rebound and hustle. In the second quarter, they started to get loose balls. They were just playing a little bit harder than us, and we knew that coming in the third quarter, we needed to get back on our just the way we played the first quarter.
How much did last year's playoff experience, how much has that helped you going through this one so far now that you have two wins?
It's helped us a lot. You know, we've been here before, and it's the playoffs, and teams are going to make runs. So we just have to be strong enough mentally and physically to just play our game.
Did you realize, I'm sure you probably talked about it in the locker room, how important the first couple minutes of the second half were going to be after they made that run? And you guys came out, I think you went 10-3 to start the second half and really opened up the lead again.
We felt that they had the momentum, so we needed to get it back. Coming into the third quarter, we just needed to make the first couple shots, and we knew that if we could kind of like equal out their momentum, then we could keep going from there.
All right, congratulations. We'll see you Friday.
Thank you.
You got it.
And that was Brian Kniff with Lauren Fields, the very talented junior for the Lady Panthers. Lauren finished with a game-high 22 points. And we're about 31 minutes away from the boys' contest. We're going to take a short break. We're going to go over the stats of the girls' game. And we will be right back right after this. And again, you're listening to high school basketball. It's the state playoffs right here on 98.7 The Coast.